Hi, I'm Jeroen from Izegrim.
Hi, I'm Marloes from Izegrim.
And you are watching
Impact Channel.
Here we are today with Marloes and Jeroen from Izegrim. Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Cheers.
Thank you for the amazing show here in Budapest.
You're welcome.
How did you feel? How did you like the crowd?
It was great.
Oh yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.
It was sweaty.
Yeah.
Unfortunately not packed. I mean, there could have been more people, but the people that were there enjoyed themselves, so
yeah.
We had a great time. I mean, that's what it's all about, you know, having a great time and talking to new friends, talking to you guys.
Oh.
having my beer, getting wine.
Yeah, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
So, do you have a favorite place to play gigs?
Wow. Ooh, that's a really hard question. Let me think about that. During this tour or
whatever.
Whatever.
Even a place that you have already played at, or something that you want to play at?
Oh, I know what I want to play. I always want to play Scandinavia. We never played in Scandinavia.
Really?
So we really want to play there sometimes. And of course the big festivals like Crosspop and Wacken and Hellfest. They're still dreams for us. They never booked us, so...
Yeah,
if you're watching, book us now!
Yeah, there's a lot on our wish list.
Yeah.
I mean, we did the 70,000 tons of metal, so that was a fabulous trip. That was amazing. That was one of the highlights in our career, I think. That was one of the best things ever. Playing on a cruise ship with 2,000 metalheads and all the luxurious you can imagine. I mean, and it's a festival, you know. You don't have to go back to your little camping site. You can go to your bunk and sleep and shower, and that was awesome.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was one of the best experiences ever. And we played here in Katowice
in
Poland with Megadeth in a really big stadium. So that was also one of our highlights. Yeah,
yeah,
really, that was really awesome. And Belgium and Germany are really good places for us to play.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, everywhere where we play, we have fun. I mean, like I said before, playing in a band should all be about fun, or if you don't have fun anymore, well, better quit. That's my opinion. I mean,
it's not the whole opinion of the whole
band. You know, it's not our job, so we don't have to make a lot of money to pay our mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
We have normal, regular jobs, so the band is fun, and I think, yeah, that's the main reason we're still making music.
Yeah.
Great. So yeah, you're mainly you're a live band. That's what you like best.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, what you said, to summarize it. And how about the songwriting part? If you could just pick one of them, like playing live or writing songs, which one would be the...
Oh, playing live.
Playing live. Definitely.
Live. It's all, you know, you have to have new records to get booked and things like that. But the main reason we're playing in a band is to play live.
And have fun with everyone. And we're also not a backstage band. We also, after the show, we always go into the crowd to talk to everyone and go on a picture, have a beer with everyone, and that's
getting
what
wasted.
We like.
Sometimes.
Yeah, that's
not
what we
time.
Like. Being in a band.
Yeah.
And what do you feel when you're on stage, when you're performing? Can you describe that feeling, actually?
I get totally soaked with sweat.
A great feeling. You can perform your songs, and especially when people are enjoying your songs, it feels so good. It gives so much energy, and you want to give more and more. And
push harder.
Push harder. And
it's like finding your own limits, what is possible. The smaller the venue, we had really small venues during this tour, but the smallest venues were most of the time not the best conditions, but the interaction was like the best, you know?
Yeah.
Like. Venue has a really large stage, high, and so you see that the people are standing in the back because else they even can see you that high, and I really like, well, that the fans are standing right to my nose, you know, that's awesome, so
And who was the craziest fan you have ever met?
The craziest fan?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think our friends from Holland, because today we got a really big surprise. We were standing on stage, and our friends from Holland came in front of the podium.
And we didn't know anything.
We didn't know anything, so a real respect for those guys, really.
That was really cool.
It's really a big surprise, yeah.
Oh, we didn't see them for 2.5 weeks and...
And then they were standing over there, huh? Yeah, that was really cool. Here in Budapest, yeah. That was really cool.
So you're spending a lot of time together when you're on tour.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get sick of each other?
No.
No.
Also, outside of the band, we see each other like every weekend and we visit concerts together and
we are real good friends. Yeah. Spending a lot of time together.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And I guess that's also helping when you write songs, because you're kind of tuned to each other.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we live near each other and when we are writing, we see each other like almost every day after our daily jobs. So sometimes it can be really hectic and intense, but yeah, it's part of the job.
We never get sick of each other. Still not happened.
I guess it won't happen anymore. But you've been together for how many years? Like 8?
Yeah, in this
since 2008 we are in this setting.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it feels good. And
wow, I'm smelly.
I really hope. Yeah, it's TV.
It's TV.
They won't tell you on the
This is a great lineup, and I don't think it will change. Not at short notice.
No. This is like a well-oiled machine. I mean, everything does their thing, and it's working perfectly for 8 years already. So
we can see that.
Yeah,
actually,
cool.
On the stage, it's like
Yeah,
and also outside of the stage, you know. Everything has its own part in the band, and that's very natural. There's no debate on certain things. It's just happening. So that's really cool. Yeah.
That's very rare. So it's really nice to hear that there are bands like that.
Yeah, sure.
Cool. Okay, so Marloes, I'm asking you a question now.
Okay.
So about your technique, was it a conscious decision that you wanted to growl or grunt like this, or was it how it came naturally to you?
Well, it came naturally, actually. I had clean vocal lessons a long time ago. I sang in a choir and I did a lot of singing things just with my normal voice. And then I started listening to metal and I really loved it. And Izegrim already had a female singer long before I entered the band. And I was always looking at her and going, wow, I really, really want to do that. She's so awesome and I must do that. I must do that. So I started trying at my Epic and I tried. And then it worked out.
It did.
It did, yeah.
Pretty well.
Yeah, oh, thank you.
And did you ever have a teacher?
Nope. Not for growling. I teach myself. But I had vocal lessons, so I know how to breathe and use my breath, but not how to grow. No, I just learned it myself.
And would you ever consider singing, like clear vocals?
No.
Please no. No.
There are a lot of bands with female vocalists who are singing clean, so no. Not,
I hate it.
Nothing for
no,
me. No,
that
you
will
hate
not
it, really?
Happen. Yeah, that will not happen in my band.
I mean,
our
you
band.
Mean, you hate her voice or you hate female singers?
Both.
Both. Yeah. I can assure you, her normal voice, you don't want to hear it. And I don't like bands like Nightwish and stuff like that.
No,
that's not my cup of tea. No.
Okay, so now that we're talking about bands like Nightwish and stuff like that, so this extreme metal scene is extremely masculine. I mean, there are not enough girls, I guess, on this scene. I mean, what do you think? Why is it so packed with men, and why is there no more women doing this?
I don't know. Actually, I never think about that. I also hear that stigma, female fronted metal, and if there's a girl and you have to call it female front. No, I'm just a girl and I can grow and I'm in a band.
She's one of the guys.
Yeah, I'm also one of the guys. No, I don't. It's cool that there are girls in metal, but why would it be special?
No, what I mean is that basically, biologically and physiologically, girls are not so different. I mean, the throat.
No, exactly.
It's all the kind of the same. So I wonder why is it so packed with men? There should be more women doing this.
No, I really don't know.
Good question, but we don't have
question.
The answer.
No.
All right then. what do you do when you're not doing music?
Working.
Yeah,
we're going out, having fun,
yeah.
And what's
paying our mortgage.
Yeah.
If I may ask, what's your work?
I am like an IT nerd, and I'm working for a local government. So and all the vacations and free time that I get from work are spent into the band. I mean, this is my summer
holiday.
From all four of us, this is our holiday. Yeah.
It must be very hard to synchronize it.
No, not really.
We have really fun together and get it together. For the jobs.
Yeah.
Oh no, we know it in time, and then we can ask for a holiday.
Yeah. I mean, this tour was planned like a half year before we go. So I mean, it's a holiday. So.
Yeah.
And what are you doing?
I work at a bank at the investment department. It's totally different, but yeah, I also have to pay my mortgage. Yeah.
Okay. And what's your hobby apart from music? Is there anything? Do you have time?
Oh,
for
game,
anything?
PlayStation.
Yeah,
PlayStation.
Yeah,
PlayStation
driving 4. Our motorcycles.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, cool.
Yeah.
And animals. I love animals.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Aww. Do you have a pet at home?
Yeah, I have a cat. And I miss her a lot.
Yeah. You should bring her on tour.
Yeah. Oh.
Teach her some vocals or something.
Yeah. I'll do a stage act.
Growl with your pussy.
That's a totally different.
Well, yeah. I guess some people can do that, but it's. Don't think that. And it.
That's a different
on,
show, people.
Yeah.
Change the channel.
What's the other channel?
Cats can do that anyway when they're on heat.
Smelly cat. Smelly cat.
Little ball of fur.
So, what was your first gig as a fan and as a musician? Do you remember?
Oh wow! I still remember that I went with my mom when I was like 16, and that's a long time ago, to Ozzy with Udo Dirk Snyder in the
a support.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
It's a cool start.
Yeah. And things like Scorpions and stuff like that. Uh-huh. And small venues in Holland.
Yeah, especially for small venues. I think.
But the biggest one I ever seen was like Ozzy.
Mm-hmm. Your first biggest one?
Yeah, that was awesome.
I think for my first biggest one, I think Bon Jovi, something like that.
Cool.
He's laughing at me.
Why? It's Bon Jovi is a legend.
A lot of small gigs. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And how old were you when you started playing?
Well, guitar, you mean?
Yeah. You're playing with yourself.
Change
the channel again.
Like, yeah,
change the channel. Yes.
16, mm-hmm. Something like that. Yeah. Like so two years ago, time. It was 2 years ago.
No. Well, I started with music a very, very long time ago when I was really young. I played different instruments, but I started to play bass in 2004.
Really?
Yeah, because before that I was a guitar player, and then I switched to bass. So since 2004 I'm playing bass.
And I guess you must like it because you can use
I like it, yeah. It's much easier than playing guitar.
Is it?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Well, I heard the opposite.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
From people who learned bass after playing the guitar. Because
it's different.
It's totally different.
It's similar,
yeah.
But it's totally
it's
different.
Totally different, yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, so... is there a person who is or was very inspirational for you?
For me, it is.
It's Opus.
That's Opus.
Okay, you will lose all your subscribers. <Yeah. laughs>
That's it.
Inspirational. I back in the days, I listened to like the old stuff, like Cacophony with. Can't remember the name from the guitar player.
Marty Friedman.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Marty Friedman, Megadeth, stuff like that, and that, and Venom, old stuff, and I started with that stuff, Possessed. Really back in the days. I mean, that was for me the inspiration to start picking up the guitar and play a bit on my attic and after school. I played more back in the days than I play now. It's really
It's a time thing.
Yeah. I don't have that much time that I used to have, but oh well. Now we are on stage and play a lot, so that's the same, actually.
Yeah.
Have you recently come across a movie or book or something like this that you would recommend to people?
don't have any time for books and stuff.
Yeah,
like that.
Well, I love movies as The Conjuring, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I like thrillers, I like horror. Yeah, I see a lot, so I I can't remember the names of the movies. But when I see the trailer again, oh yeah, that one was really cool.
Yeah, I'm the same. I never can remember the title. Yeah.
No, and it's like, oh, you have to see it. Oh yeah, yeah, I'm gonna check it out. And then you watch YouTube. Oh, I already saw it. Yeah, that's really funny.
Same thing happens to me all the time. Okay, so you have tattoos, both of you.
Yeah.
Can you please talk about them? Why do you have these tattoos in particular?
Oh, I can talk about
it. Yeah, he's got a really great story.
All the things that are connected to the band. Everything. Okay. And I actually, it was like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I was like 2 days here in Budapest, and I got tattooed in 2 days, two full days, and it was done
grind
in grind design. I think you have to wait like 1 year before you get an appointment. And the whole story about the band is like it's an old myth.
Yeah.
With just animals in it, mm-hmm. and it got a lion and a bear and a wolf, and the name of the band, Izegrim, is the character the wolf,
yeah.
and it also means very grumpy and there, and it fits the music. Mm-hmm. So I got the lion and the wolf and the fox and the bear, and I want to have more. And it's just a picture, but it means a lot to me.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't do any names or stuff like that. I mean, when the band quits, it's still a nice picture about that story that I like. So for me, and the grind design guy does a lot with animals. So that was for me. Yeah, I had to wait for a year, but it was well worth it. And 2 days in a row was pretty awful, but
but it's done.
It's done, and yeah. So
it looks really
and I have to go further, but yeah, there are
you
a lot
have
of
to wait another year.
Yeah, exactly. yeah.
And
I got we all made a tattoo on the 70,000 tons of metal. So I got Miami here, and here I did a thing for my dad that passed away like 6 or 7 years ago. So. But that's a whole different story. I'll keep that for myself.
We respect that.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Well, that's the same with my tattoo. It's a family thing. And that's all I wanted to say about it.
Yeah.
Well,
okay.
Yeah.
It's beautiful, actually.
Yeah, thank you.
So, what is it that you are the most grateful for in your life?
This. That we can do this and in good health. And
especially good health.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of shit going on in the world. And and we're healthy and happy, and we can drink beers, and we don't have to worry about money and stuff like that, and we don't have to eat out of trash cans, for instance. I mean, we have a very luxurious life, and
we all know it.
We are very aware of it, and we really appreciate that. And I think that's the most important thing in life.
I totally agree.
Nothing more, nothing less.
No.
And if you could eliminate one thing from the world, what would it be?
The fucking terrorists. Man. Yeah. Today again in Stockholm, and I don't want to say much about it, but it's
yeah, but terrorism in general. I mean, you know, a guy like Breivik is also a terrorist. You know, who shot all those people in Finland?
I think. Norway.
Norway.
Sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah. Well. Yeah. That's pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
Yeah, and now we arrive to one of my other questions, which is, for me, it's a bit of a controversy, because you sing about all these grim things, the last album had this concept of a murderer waiting to be executed. But when I look at you, you're so happy people and like grateful people and everything. So it's a bit of a controversy for me. Where is this coming from?
From my head.
I'm
really sick in my head. Yeah. That's why I've got this blonde hair and no one knows this.
I do the same, yes.
You see? Yeah.
You see people?
We love girls. We are crazy.
Yes. But we seem innocent. And that's the point.
That's the whole point.
Oh,
cool. Okay, so do you write all the lyrics?
Yep. I write them all, and we all think about a concept or something like that, or I listen to the music. And the ferryman's aunt, he came with the idea, he saw a statue in Ireland.
Yeah.
And that was called the ferryman's aunt?
Yeah, it was called the ferryman's aunt. It's like a big park with all crazy stuff.
Yeah, it's abandoned.
It's Victoria's Garden.
Yeah, exactly.
In Wicklow. I love it.
Yeah, and that there was a statue from the ferryman, and he was coming out of the water like
he's actually
a monster.
Sinking,
yeah, he's sinking with the ropes and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I thought, that's fucking awesome. So, write lyrics about that subject.
Yeah. So. So I wrote an album.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you've been to Ireland?
No, I saw it on the internet.
You saw?
Yeah, yeah. I have to go there.
I've been there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we like really 12, have to
12,
go there.
10,
yeah.
10 or 12 statues, right?
Something no, it's like much that. More. It's
more?
I lived there. It's a whole park.
Yeah, okay.
It's, it's a meditational park. It's amazing. You should go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If it still exists. This is from there, actually.
Oh, really? Cool.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Awesome.
So, where do you go to relax and recharge your batteries when you want to be away from the noise and everything? Do you have time for that again?
No.
Well, at home.
Yeah. But well, relax. I do that in a bar. Drink beer. Okay. Yeah.
Sometimes I like to be alone at home. Mm-hmm. Just be me and my cat. Watching a movie and then I can relax. Yeah. Not every weekend, but so now and then I really need that. Just get away from all the craziness.
And when you don't listen to metal, what do you listen to? What kind of metal?
Oh, normally the radio. I mean, I'm not dedicated. I love metal, but I can't listen to it all day. I mean, some people will shoot me right now, but I'm honest about it. I mean, I can listen to rap music or old school blues music or whatever is on the radio, as long as it has to do something with real instruments. You know,
mm-hmm.
I don't like the
techno stuff.
The techno stuff and stuff like that. But as long as somebody is on stage and I see sweat and I see a real instrument, I'm happy. You know,
yeah.
I'm really happy. So yeah, I enjoy all kinds of music and yeah, I'm not afraid to say that because there are a lot of metalheads that would shoot me for saying that you're not a true metalhead. Blah blah blah. You know,
you shouldn't care about that.
No, exactly.
Yeah.
So I listen to the radio a lot. I mean, mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've got a couple of bands I listen to. Queen is my all-time favorite band, so I listen to it a lot. At Muse and Alter Bridge. Yeah, I love those bands. And after that, little radio songs. But what he said, with a real band.
Yeah, as long as it's real music,
yeah.
not like a USB key into a laptop and have an audience of 30,000 people
yeah.
with just one USB key. I mean, that's, okay. That's like crazy.
And is there a Dutch band that is not so well known abroad, but you think they should be well known?
There are a lot of great Dutch bands.
Yeah.
Can you please recommend some?
Well, my friends, the old school death metal band Body Farm,
they
are doing really great things. The Heritons is also a great band. That's like Gothenburg style. Like In Flames and stuff like that. And the obvious band like Asphyx and Pestilence and stuff like that.
Them.
But
yeah.
Those are the
Martyr.
Knows. Martyr.
Also
it's
great.
Yeah. This old school heavy metal.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's more the kind of Flotsam and Jetsam kind of thing. That's pretty cool.
I did
band.
A song with them and Dautus, also a death metal band. I also did a song with them. So go check them out on internet.
Yeah.
Okay, so if a metalhead goes to Netherlands, where does he or she have to go to?
In the Netherlands?
Mm-hmm.
It's not. Everybody goes to Amsterdam, but
but I mean, is there a place like a pub or a certain
I like
town or whatever?
Excalibur in Amsterdam is a pretty cool place. It's a really small place run. Yeah, I think it's run by the Hells Angels, but I don't. Yeah, it's pretty cool place. It's on the red light district, so that's a pretty cool place to hang around.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of cool venues, and
But you're not from the capital?
No.
As I know.
No. We're from near the German border, so we live in the east of Holland. Yeah.
All right. Okay, so if you would have 3 wishes, what would they be?
A lot of money.
Yeah. health forever. Good health forever.
Yeah.
And for my parents.
Jesus, I don't know. I'm happy. I don't have any. I don't have so much to wish for.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Good to hear.
Could say like peaceful whole world, but I know that the.
It's like the models always do.
Yeah,
I
yeah,
want
yeah.
peace in the world.
We're
but
not
then what would you write about?
If yeah, exactly.
Peace?
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah, and there won't be any economy and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, yeah. No, I'm happy.
Yeah. And we're not at a
Miss
Universe contest, so no. Yeah. We don't have to say stupid things like world peace and stuff like that.
And we're much more beautiful than those girls.
Ah. You both.
You too.
I'm not a girl. Fuck you.
You got long hair.
I never said you're a girl. Okay. I just said we're all beautiful.
Okay.
Yeah, we're beautiful.
Cool.
Okay, so.
You having me to Thailand?
Yeah. All girls are boys.
Yeah.
If you would do a tribute song, which band would you do it for?
For me, it's Queen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Oh, I would do Queen too. Yeah, yeah, I think so. Yeah, yeah.
Thank
you. Do you have actually a song that you would pick? Do you know?
Oh, there are a lot of songs. There are a lot of songs I love.
Fat Bottom Girl, yeah.
But for what?
Fat Bottom Girl.
Fat Bottom Girl, yeah. Bicycle Race, then. Now, I think for metal, it's cool to do the Princess of the Universe thing. Because it's already a fast song. And for the rest, I don't know.
We even talked about that.
Yeah,
I think
we never
Bart,
did.
Bart made an intro from that song.
Yeah, we never finished it.
No.
We should do it.
Yeah, we
could.
Yeah.
It's on our wish list now.
You're bringing up good ideas.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Cool.
It was worse to come here then.
Yeah, yeah.
And if somebody would decide to do an Izegrim tribute album.
Tribute album?
Yeah.
That's
stop it. Stop it. Don't do it.
No, which bands would you like to hear on it?
Oh, wow.
Oh. I don't know. I really don't care. I mean, if someone's playing my song of our songs,
I would
be very honored.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
We could ask Flotsam.
Yeah.
They would do.
They've got something to do tomorrow.
No, no idea which bands. No. Name a few bands, Opus. Help us out.
Do Sentence.
Yeah,
do Sentence, Flotsam and Jetsam.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Ozzy.
Ozzy. Oh, Ozzy. But he can't remember any lyrics. So that's what we
he's been out of cue.
Yeah. Man. Talking about old legends.
Yeah.
Ozzy. Mm.
Do you have any other musical projects apart from Izegrim?
Nope.
Are you planning?
No. No. Okay. It's too busy. Our drummer has another band, and he is a drum professional. He earns his money with playing music,
mm-hmm.
or teaching music, actually. And he has got another band. So, yeah. But the rest of us is just Izegrim, and that's it. And that's enough.
Yeah.
I don't want to spend my to divide my attention between two or three bands.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can't do that, I think. No.
No, we're dedicated to Izegrim.
Yeah, exactly.
Everything we write is for that band.
Yeah, exactly.
I hate it to think about the lyrics, are they for this band or for that band?
Mm-hmm.
No. I just want one band and
it's enough.
Yeah.
Okay. And what are the plans of the band for the rest of the year?
Record a new album, but we have to write a lot before we can record. So I think a new album will be scheduled for next year. Mm-hmm. So
we are in writing modus. But
yeah, and we have a little tour in Spain coming up at the end of the year, so that will be pretty awesome. And some
gigs.
Some separate weekend gigs and stuff like that. And for the rest, we will write our asses off.
Yeah.
And do you have an idea, maybe? Or will it be a concept album as well?
Oh, I really don't know.
No. We always first write the music,
mm-hmm.
and then we are thinking, or she's thinking about the concept and stuff like that. So,
also
music
wanna
is first.
I want to hear the songs.
Okay.
So to get a certain feeling, mm-hmm. and then I know what kind of lyrics I want to write.
Yeah.
Let the music come.
Mm-hmm. So, my last three questions are coming.
Three, okay.
Yes.
Cool.
Okay.
What are your five favorite albums of all times?
Oh! That's so fucking off. Oh, I will skip this one. I don't know.
Well, I know. Nevermore. Huh. Enemies of Reality. I love it a lot. And all albums by Queen. So.
Mm-hmm.
I love
Muse.
Muse, but not one particular album. And Alter Bridge, I love a lot of albums. And
I would go by the more old stuff, things like
Anthrax,
Amongst the Living, and stuff like that. I'm
old school. More old school, yeah.
Yeah, and Tomb stuff, and Black Sabbath, and
Iron Maiden, like that.
You know, I'm really
Flotsam and Jetsam.
I don't care about actually about very new bands. I mean, I don't follow the news. The news with metal concerning. I'm stuck to the old bands. And that's fine with me. Yeah, old school death metal I like very much. And actually also things like Nevermore, the melodic stuff, and In Flames and stuff like that.
You know? The old In Flames.
Yeah, old In Flames. Yeah. So that would be my top 5 pick. Something like that.
It's hard. We listen to a lot of albums, so
yeah.
To pick only 5, that's hard.
Yeah, it's too hard. Yeah. And when I say 5 albums right now, the next minute I was fuck no.
I meant that one.
Yeah.
Oh, that's all right.
Yeah.
So, what's the meaning of life?
Be this. Happy.
This beer.
Yeah.
It's a Soproni. Soproni. That's Soproni. The meaning. Soproni. Oh. Yeah.
Soproni.
And wine. No. It's
be happy, do the things you like.
Yeah.
And
don't be an ass and enjoy life. That's the main thing.
Do you have a message to the fans and to the world?
Well, do everything you like and buy our albums, come to our shows. And well, that's it.
And have a great time.
Yeah, have a great time.
That's what music is all about, having a great time. At least for us, it's what it's all about, having a great time. So.
Enjoy the good things in life.
Yeah, and drink beer with us.
Yeah. Yeah. Or wine.
Or wine, or whiskey, or whatever. And thank you all for watching.
Yeah.
Because this was the last question, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. No, not cool. It was a great conversation. Sorry. That came out the wrong way, but you know what I mean.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, thank you for watching. Yeah. Thank you for having us on your interview and on your YouTube page. Channel. YouTube channel.
Okay, great. Thanks very much for your
time. Thank you. Thank you both.
Yes, thank you. Yeah.
Thanks to the man behind the camera.
Yeah, thanks
and
to Opus.
And the man behind the man behind the camera. It's awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.